So a few days ago, the official release of Welcome to the NHK released from the original author Tatsuhiko Takimoto. It's called Rebuild of Welcome to the NHK. Takimoto's intent with this was to go back and readdress some of the negative issues surrounding the ending of the novel as well as the anime, because they do share compatible endings there, even though the novel's ending is much more detailed. He wanted to go back to address some of that and also brighten things up a bit and add some positivity to it, and this is his attempt at doing that. This is a self-contained, fully-fledged sequel, according to his own words. This is a sequel. Because I follow him on Instagram, that's why I know what he was saying. You know, he's been hyping this up forever, for months at least, just saying, well, hey, I'm working on the new NHK, it's gonna be this, it's gonna be that, I'm working on it. It seemed like he was working on it almost every day. So I had higher hopes for it. So whenever he said it was out, I found it on Amazon, I bought it without even looking at the page to it, and I just set it aside until I go to the park the next day and read it. So I went out there, it was like a special day for me, just hanging out during the weekday, the weather was great, had some tea with me, and just reading it. I was flipping through, it's the ebook version of it. So there I was just flipping through the pages. I thought, this text is kind of big. There's not really a whole lot going on each page. And I flipped the page, and then I realized, like, hey, wait a minute. This thing's only 33 pages long. What is this? And after I finished, I realized it's only actually like 25 pages long, and there's a writer's note at the end of it, which takes up almost a third of the entire book, I guess you can say. I exported this and I imported it into the program that I use, the website and everything that I use to analyze text, and it's less than 5,000 words. My previous video on beating anime burnout, it was like 3,000 something, the original script for that was, and because you know, I edited it down a little bit, but so basically the book is just shy of being longer than a script for one of my videos are. There are fan fictions that go in more in depth than this. But look at this. Okay, so this is one page right here. This is what you're getting. It's just, there's no paragraphs. There's nothing here. It's just a few conversations. There's one conversation with Sato and Misaki where she's trying to help him out from being a hikikomori. There's one with Yamazaki where they're still working on the game and not making any progress. And then there's one with Senpai. She's still abusing drugs and she's still a conspiracy theorist. So how much of the original story is Takimoto trying to retcon by creating this little short story here? Because the best parts, in my opinion, the best parts of the original story happened in the last half of the last third of it. When Yamazaki moves away, he's gone. This is retconned in this. He had to move away to the countryside because something happened with his family and he had to go work on their business. And that's retconned here. Misaki, she detailed her abuse where people were putting cigarette butts out on her. She detailed her, she alluded to her mother's suicide. We get to see what it was like for her living in this cult and her trying to use religion as a tool to pry herself away from her depression. And of course, the ending. The ending to this was great. It was better than the anime. Of course, you know, the novel came first. And all of that is retconned thanks to this. This little tiny story that doesn't even have paragraphs. It's just dialogue going back and forth. And on top of that, what is the setting? The setting is retcon. There's PS5s in this. There is Twitter. There is, you know, they talk about energy drinks and, you know, Line and all this other stuff. This is a modern story, but the original story came out in like, the original story was set in the early to mid 2000s. So either Misaki is the oldest high schooler in history. She's like 30 something years old, or there's a time skip, or there was poor translation. I don't know, because there's no detailing here surrounding this. They just say, oh, Misaki's a high schooler or something like that. What is this? There is no author's note. There's no intro, or there's an author's note at the end, but that doesn't detail anything that's happening in the beginning. There's no introductory chapter that would explain anything. What is my inspiration for doing this? What am I hoping to achieve by writing on this? There's nothing. It just goes straight into the dialogue and it means nothing. It's only like 20 some pages long. It goes nowhere. What is this the sequel to? Where is this going? I don't get it. This should have just been filler content. And okay, maybe I'm being a little too harsh on this, but it's titled Rebuild of Welcome to the NHK. Its description is, it is the official sequel to Welcome to the NHK. What I see it is, this is false advertising. And one of the things that get me so heated is because I uploaded numerous videos over my history of doing YouTube about Welcome to the NHK, and some of those videos, they're gone. I was very candid about how I relate to the story of Welcome to the NHK, the social issues, because I really related to NHK because I was working back then when I first saw the anime. It was just work, home, work, home, work, home. No social life. Occasionally I'd go on a date. Occasionally I would have a relationship or whatever. But there was no, like, friendships. There was no social circle. I didn't have a social life or anything like that. It was just work, home, work, home. And it was really depressing. And I made a video talking about that. And of course, there's also reclusive tendencies there where I didn't have a job and I was just home and I would just never go outside for like months and months at a time. And I really related to that, especially, you know, doing YouTube. It's like I'm here all the time and it's kind of nerve-wracking sometimes, though it's also tranquil in a way. But I made videos talking about my experiences and how I relate to the story, and people left me messages, Bob, I relate with you. I relate with the story. I'm in tears. This has been life-changing for me talking about the anime. It's been life-changing for them because it really put things into perspective for them because they didn't have anybody to talk to about these issues. They didn't even know that there was an issue. They thought that they were the ones who were wrong and messed up and that, you know, nobody else in the world deals with problems like that. NHK strikes a nerve with certain people. Some people, they don't get it. They think, oh, it's a comedy. It's a dark comedy. They don't get it. And some people think, oh, it's cool to be a hikikomori or something. It's fashionable because what do these other anime do? I've had messages from a lot of people who emotionally connect and they get it. And when I see this, I feel like those people are being taken advantage of. I feel like I was misled into buying this. Honestly, I would have rather have just donated Takimoto $7 for nothing, because if I did that, then I wouldn't be establishing that it's okay for him to put out work like this and for me to pay $7 for it, because it's not. So my only recommendation here is that you do not buy this. Do not read it. It's a waste of time, in my opinion. I feel like it will be a waste of yours as well. If you want to support the author, go to his website. There's probably a donation link there. If you disagree with me, I want to know why. Let me know. I'm not trying to argue or anything. Just let me know. Don't dislike and leave. I want to know why you agree that this is worth $7. And more importantly, I want to know why you think that this story here, this tiny little story that doesn't even have paragraphs, it's only 20-some pages with big font, why you think these 4,000-some words are worth retconning and deleting things in the original story, such as, one, the ending, the part where they were on the cliff, in the novel, the part where Sato and Misaki spent the night in Misaki's abandoned childhood home, no longer happened, deleted. Yamazaki, moving away. I know they're good friends and people probably wanted him to stay, but there's also a lot of character development in that, and there's also a lot of drama added and tension added to the story, which makes the story more emotional. That's deleted. Everything that we know about Misaki, cigarette burns, her mother's suicide, what it's like for her to live with her grandparents, the religious stuff, all this stuff, that is all deleted, retcon, because this story exists prior to that event. Times where Sato and Misaki went on dates in the cafes and stuff that her grandparents owned. Gone, all gone. So if you disagree with me in that, that's what, in my opinion, that's what you're agreeing, that all of that stuff should be deleted. In my opinion, that's some of the best parts of the novel. That's actually the best parts of the novel, because what you're left with is drug use and, like, pedo stuff. It's not good. Aside from that. So that's why I feel like not only is this bad from a narrative perspective, but it's also really misleading, and I feel like it's taken advantage of a lot of people who are, their hearts are just won over by Welcome to the NHK because they relate to it due to all the social issues and stuff. So that's all I've got to say about this. Hopefully my unscripted ramblings were coherent, and, you know, this is why I script videos, kind of scatterbrained. You know, it's easier to make unscripted videos if you do them for a while, but this is my first unscripted video in probably a couple years, so it's kind of rough for me. Anyways, thank you all for watching. I'll see you next time. Have an awesome day. And my next video is Genshiken. That hopefully should be out in a few days, sometime this week. I'm reviewing the entire series, all of its sequels and everything, not only the anime, but the manga as well. Thank you for watching. I'll see you then.